Thank you. Thanks for having me. How are things? Could not be better.
Is that true?
I mean, you've had a hell of a run, so for you to say it could not be better, that's a pretty good place to be, isn't it?
Well, yeah.
Kick out the Jets. Wayne Kramer. Stromble.
To the kind of crowds that I get to play for every night, with the musicians that have kindly agreed to do it with me, terrific.
It's not, certainly the musicians that I've spoken to who have played with you, or just the way people speak about you and your band, it's not just because of the MC5 and that one song. It's the man you are and what you've done and what you've experienced and what you fight for now. I mean, that's the inspiration. It's amazing how, you know, Kick of the Jams is incredible, but that's not the most impressive thing about what you do. Your contribution to society.
Well, my goal is to leave the place a little nicer than I found it.
When did that become the goal?
Well, in a way, it was kind of always there. I mean, when I was young, I was an activist and cared intensely about the world around me, my friends, my community, my country.
Your country.
My planet. But, you know, it's really become a first principle in the last 20 years, I'd say.
You're the only person I know who's had a song written about his time in jail, who's now in prison and now working on behalf of, but using the same title.
Yeah.
I mean, talk about, first of all, talk about the project and what you do.
Yeah, we're referring to Jail Guitar Doors.
Right.
We are a 501c3 nonprofit corporation based in Los Angeles. What we do is simple. We find people that work in corrections that are willing to use music as a tool for violence prevention and prisoner rehabilitation. Also aids in reentry. And we provide musical instruments, mostly guitars, but some electric instruments, sometimes entire band rigs, beat boxes for the hip-hop world,
yeah.
and our instruments are in over 120 American prisons, and I think we're in a couple here in Canada. And we also run songwriting workshop programs, which are really self-expression exercises.
To be heard, to feel like your voice matters, to feel like your name matters is incredibly important, isn't it?
Absolutely. Everyone has a story, and especially people that live in prisons, they have extraordinary stories, and they need to have their story heard. And we provide them with an environment that they can do that, that's structured and that's positive. We have some rules in our workshops, and amongst those are there can be no violence, no intimidation, that we can talk about anybody and anything, but we have to treat each other with dignity and respect. There can be no sexist humor, no racist humor, no banging on the mic, and no disrespecting women.
Right.
And this is a safe space. Everybody loves to have a safe space in prison, where we leave all prison politics out on the yard.
Right.
And what happens in our workshops is we're human beings. We're artists in our workshops.
And so you've seen this transformation in the people's lives that you work with inside?
Over and over and over again. Yeah, it's fabulous.
We're approaching, I think it's the 27th, it's Red Rodney's birthday. What do you remember as a Red Rodney?
Oh, man, that guy.
Great trumpeter.
Unbelievable. Trumpeters still today do not play at the level that Red played at. His facility and the velocity that he could play at, and his imagination, his sense of melody, and his ears. I mean, he had it was unbelievable. I mean, we'd listen to records, and he'd just call out the chords. Oh, yeah, B-flat.